Welcome to Haslett Elementary's new library. This is an open concept library. It allows the library to serve as the heart of the school. Students can come and go throughout the day, easily accessing student books and library resource materials. And this is the type of environment that we want to be open and encouraging for our new elementary schools. We're now in our new maker space at our elementary schools. This is a great space that provides a lot of flexibility. It allows students to do things from circuits to Legos to rockets, all within the confines of being able to work together in a very flexible space. It opens into the library and it opens out into the courtyard, so it could actually serve as a presentation area as well. Everything from the furniture is flexible. It can move around to truly the power that they may need for some of their work. It's flexible and can go right back up into the ceiling. So here we are at Hatfield Elementary Library. Obviously a pretty big difference compared to our new prototype elementary school libraries. It is an enclosed space. The furniture is not flexible, it's stationary, and it just doesn't have that open feel that becomes the heart of the school like we've tried to do in that new prototype. So this is another unique feature in our new schools, both at the elementary level, middle school level, and high school level, is these foldable partitions between each classroom. It allows for classrooms to collaborate together or work independently. These walls are also magnetic as well as dry erase. So you can see they have magnets on them. They're pinning up students' work, but at the same time, they're very easily maneuverable to open up to the other classroom and share classrooms between teachers. Here's one of our existing classrooms at one of our older campuses. You can see there's more stationary items, built-in bookcases, built-in lockers, and it doesn't have the flexible wall between the two classrooms that we're seeing and we're putting in our new elementary schools. That wall that has that magnetic ability, that dry erase board material, as well as being able to open that wall and cross-collaborate between classrooms. This is a brand new space for us. This is a grade level planning area, so each two grades share this space. In this one, the first grade shares from this side, and second grade shares from the other side of the hallway. This is a great space for teachers to come together and collaborate their planning lessons as well as their students' individual goals. This is the new prototype design for our cafeterias at our elementary schools that serve 850 students. Unlike the cafeterias at Seven Hills and Hatfield, which serve 650 and 450 respectively, this cafeteria allows for a transitional space for performances that could seat even more than 850 if needed. Here we are at Hatfield Elementary, their cafeteria, and this actually houses only about 450 students. You can see the cafeteria size is much smaller than what we're doing at our new elementaries. So we're standing here on a typical Northwest ISD new standard playground for our upper elementary kids. What I really want to show you today is the surface that's here. This is a rubberized mulch that's bonded together. It's not your traditional wood chips. And so we want to be able to put that surface everywhere. It allows more accessibility for students to be able to get onto the playgrounds without taking some of those wood chips home. And it also provides a more cushioned fall area for them. In addition, part of the bond is also looking towards adding more handicap accessible play elements on our playgrounds. So putting those elements in place, as well as providing a surface that our students can get to those elements to play with and to stay engaged with their classmates. Here we are at one of our other older campuses, playgrounds, and as you can tell, it has the wood fiber chips in lieu of that rubberized fiber that we talked about earlier. It does make it a little bit more difficult for children with accessibility needs to get onto the playground, as well as if you look at the playground, this is one of those playgrounds we would want to upgrade and provide more accessibility components for those children.